In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you lift up the brokenhearted. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are mighty in power. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you humbled yourself to show us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Is not man's life on earth a drudgery? said, I say, shall I rise? Then the night drags on. I am filled with restlessness until the dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle. They come to an end without hope. Remember that my life is like the wind. I shall not see happiness again. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
according to Mark. On leaving the synagogue, Jesus entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with a fever. They immediately told him about her. He approached, grasped her hand, and helped her up. Then the fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening, after sunset, they brought to him all who were ill or possessed by demons. The whole town was gathered at the door. He cured many who were sick with various diseases, and he drove out many demons, not permitting them to speak, because they knew him. Rising very early, before dawn, he left and went off to a deserted place where he prayed. Simon and those who were with him pursued him, and on finding him said, "Everyone is looking for you." He told them, "Let us go to the nearby villages that I may preach there also. For this purpose have I come." So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout all the whole of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus healed Simon's mother-in-law of a fever. He cured many who were sick with various diseases, and he drove out many demons. Jesus goes to the nearby villages to preach. Any way we look at it, Jesus is very busy in this gospel passage. We are so caught up in all of the healing and preaching that takes place in this passage that it is very easy to overlook a very critical verse. Regarding Jesus, the verse states, rising very early before dawn, he left and went off to a deserted place where he prayed. Jesus is the master physician. He is the master healer. But Jesus is also a man of prayer. Even he realized that he had to take a break from time to time. Why do we find it so hard to take a break? Why do we feel that unless we are busy every minute of the day, that somehow we are not living up to our full potential? Will the world come to a screeching halt if we disconnect from all of our electronic gadgets for 15 or 30 minutes a day? We do not have to spend every waking moment on Facebook, texting, or glued to our computers. Every now and then, we need to pull the earbuds out of our ears. Maybe it is time to get back to some basics. Maybe we need to follow the example of our Lord and Savior. Find some quiet place, find some quiet time, and just pray. I know all the excuses. We are too busy. Too many demands are placed on our time. Not enough hours in the day. We are just too tired. I get it. I understand. We are all overworked. We are all overextended. We are all burning the candle at both ends. To what purpose, however, I have yet to figure out. None of us has any more demands placed on us than the demands placed on our Lord and Savior. Still, he found time to pray. And if Jesus could find time to pray, then so can we. So this week, let us be very intentional about prayer. Let us make time to spend with the Lord, because as busy as we all are, taking quiet time for prayer just might be what we need to quiet our minds and to quiet our hearts. Please remain seated. During this Mass, the catechumens who are on a journey to enter into full communion with the Roman Catholic Church will be anointed at this Mass. So at this time, I invite the catechumens, Melanie Spicer, Natalie Yockey, Caitlin Merriam, and Carson Merriam to please come forward. Sent by the Father and anointed by the Spirit, when you read in the synagogue in Nazareth, you fulfilled the words of the prophet Isaiah that proclaimed liberty to captives and announced the season of forgiveness. We pray for these, your servants, who have opened their ears and hearts to your word. Ask your moment of grace. Do not let their minds be troubled, or their lives be tied to earthly desires. Do not let them remain estranged from the hope of your promises or enslaved by a spirit of unbelief. Rather, let them believe in you, whom the Father has established as universal Lord and to whom he has subjected all things. Let them submit themselves to the Spirit of grace, so that with hope in their calling, they may join the priestly people and share in the abundant joy of the New Jerusalem, where you live and remain forever and ever. Amen. Melanie, Natalie, Caitlin, and Carson, we anoint you with the oil of salvation in the name of Christ our Savior. May he strengthen you with his power, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Let us pray. God of power, look upon these, your servants, as they deepen their understanding of the gospel. Grant that they may come to know and love you, and always heed your will with receptive minds and generous hearts. Teach them through this time of preparation, and enfold them within your church, so that they may share your holy mysteries, both on earth and in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear friends, these catechumens, who are our sisters and brother, have already traveled a long road. We rejoice with them in the gentle guidance of God who brought them to this day. Let us pray that they may press onwards until they come to share fully in our way of life.
For the church, that by preaching the gospel in word and deed, many may come to be saved. we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those called to leadership in the world, that they may work diligently to end every form of abuse, oppression, and persecution. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the displaced and homeless, that they will receive a welcome and shelter in their time of need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of this community of faith, that we might be able to follow the Lord's example of finding quiet time away. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lead the departed into the light of your dwelling place, including Eden Roseman Hiller, Derek Kaiser, and Francis Schuster, that they may gaze upon you for all eternity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of the intentions listed in our parish book of prayer, and for all of the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for the Scout organization throughout the world, and for the Scout groups at St. Elizabeth Ann Seton Parish, that they continue to reflect the light and love of Christ in word, thought, and action. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God our Father may reveal Christ to our catechumens more and more with every passing day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
My dear friends, this community now sends you forth to reflect more deeply upon the Word of God, which you have shared with us today. Be assured of our loving support and prayers for you. We look forward to the day when you will share fully in the Lord's table. Go in peace, and may the Lord remain with you always.